Like so many of us, I have a lot of favorite filmmakers and have been inspired by a lot of different artists. Wes Anderson, Steven Spielberg, Edgar Wright, Ryan Johnson, Lana and Lily Wachowski. But there has always been one particular person who stood out amongst my filmmaking heroes. And that would be this man right here. His name is Gore Verbinski. Verbinski is a strange name, admittedly, to mention as being one of my favorite filmmakers because, in all honesty, he isn't a household name like Steven Spielberg, or an art house auteur like Wes Anderson, or a trailblazing revolutionary of the art form like the Wachowski sisters. Whenever I bring him up, I feel met with confused stares and long pauses. His name may not be familiar to some of you, I'm sure, but I would be surprised if you had not seen a good deal of his work, his most notable of which being the original Pirates of the Caribbean trilogy, The Curse of the Black Pearl, Dead Man's Chest, and At World's End. To many of you still, it might seem like such an odd choice to make a video about Gore Verbinski, of all people, whose last film was released 6 years ago, mind you, when there are so many beloved filmmakers that are popular in the cultural zeitgeist right now, and who are putting out acclaimed, decade-defining stuff as we speak. And I'm sure there's people watching this probably doubting if he's even got a distinct voice as a filmmaker, a unique style, ideas to express, themes to explore. That's certainly how the talk around a lot of his work felt to me back in the 2010s. After all, it is entirely possible that my adoration for Verbinski could be a complete bias, right? But I'm here to say that Gore Verbinski is not just an overlooked and underrated filmmaker, but one of the most brilliant, unique, and visually distinct filmmakers of his time. Verbinski's ideas are eccentric and wild. Nearly all of his films are imbued with deep fascination for the macabre and the bizarre, and Verbinski is continually trying to express those macabre and bizarre ideas in new ways that are fresh and audacious. When you watch a film by Gore Verbinski, you leave having seen things you thought you would never see on the big screen. Imagery ranging all the way from gleefully entertaining to genuinely thought-provoking, sometimes simultaneously. Imagery like the death of an antagonist and his empire, which represent the collapse of colonialism and capitalism, or a Western dream sequence that breaks down the fear of loneliness.
Where are your friends now?
Verbinski dialogue sequences look like this. Verbinski romance looks like this. Verbinski's character information is communicated like this. Verbinski's unique visual style, he is extremely versatile and has the capability to work in any genre. His talent as a filmmaker extends far beyond his blockbuster action films. He has made absolutely hilarious slapstick comedies like MouseHunt, genuinely frightening horror films like The Ring, melancholy character studies like The Weatherman, oddball personal art pieces like A Cure for Wellness, and subversive rom-coms like The Mexican. Verbinski breathes life into all of these vastly different genres with ease while never having to compromise his artistic voice in the process. Each film, no matter how different, has Verbinski's love for filmmaking painted across every frame. I also consider Verbinski to be one of the best action filmmakers that the medium has quite likely ever seen. His style combines the one-take techniques of Steven Spielberg, the slapstick of Buster Keaton, the dark creativity of Guillermo del Toro, the ingenuity of Sam Raimi, the scale of Peter Jackson, and the heroism of Brad Bird to craft sequences that blow you away through their rigorous storyboarding and blocking. I've always been so struck by the rhythmic pace of Verbinski's action. There is an undeniable silent film-esque edge to the way he directs action. Music informs motion with Verbinski. Everything has a beat and momentum to the point where it feels like you're watching a hypnotic dance in a way. This kind of rhythm can be seen in smaller action sequences earlier on in his career, like with Will and Jack's fight from Curse of the Black Pearl, and can be traced all the way to bigger action sequences like the glorious Maelstrom battle from Our World's End. But one of Verbinski's finest moments, to me, comes from the finale of The Lone Ranger, a train heist set piece that contains all of the emotion, adrenaline, filmmaking spectacle, and fun that you could ever want from a summer blockbuster. There's a channel called Film Music Media that excellently covered this action sequence in extensive detail and perfectly breaks down Verbinski's style and the tremendous amount of work that he puts into his art, and I'll link that in the description. I highly recommend that you check it out. Please do. I don't think Verbinski's films are just style over substance. I think there's deep thematic meaning to them that impacts me in ways that most films rarely do. A common theme that I see in Verbinski's work is the theme of self-expression, identity, freedom, liberation of the body and mind, loving yourself and others for who they are, things like that. In his Pirates of the Caribbean trilogy, Jack's entire arc throughout the three films revolves around his struggle to find his humanity, his freedom. He has to dig deep within himself in order to discover the good that others know he is capable of. In Rango, the whole point of the film is to find one's true calling, who they are meant to be. Rango's journey is a journey of self-discovery, a journey of being able to find solace within himself after years of feeling lost and alone. The Lone Ranger is very similar to Rango in this regard, as John Reed's journey echoes Rango's in many respects. MouseHunt, as silly as that movie may be, is a story about a broken family. It explores prospects of learning to accept your family for who they are, loving them as who they are, not as who you want or need them to be. The Weatherman is about a man trying to find stability and purpose while his job and home life crumble around him. And A Cure for Wellness is all about systems of power trying to maintain control over people through convincing them that they need to be cured of their own identities. These themes can be found throughout Verbinski's entire body of work and have genuine impacts on me. There is barely a day that goes by where I don't tear up just thinking about Jack's emotional growth or the internal enlightenment that Rango finds. Or lose my mind contemplating the infinite layers of messed up that lie within A Cure for Wellness. Anyone who knows me personally understands how deeply vital of a role the original Pirates of the Caribbean trilogy has played in not just my filmmaking journey, but in my life as a whole. They are the reason I love film. They are the reason I make films. They are the reason I'm writing the script for this video essay right now. I even have a Pirates of the Caribbean tattoo on my left arm. They are the reason I am who I am. In terms of Pirates of the Caribbean alone, I owe Gore so much for all the memories and imagination that those films gave to me when I was young. But even beyond that, he continued to be an inspiration to me during my younger years through films like Rango and The Lone Ranger, the latter of which I am aware is infamous for being a huge critical and financial bomb, but one that 10-year-old me passionately championed throughout its entire marketing campaign because I knew who was involved and unquestionably believed in the magic that his films held for me. And when it finally released on June 22nd, 2013, that 10-year-old girl could not have cared less about the box office numbers or the Rotten Tomatoes score. And to be honest with you, I still don't. I'm always going to be a defender of The Lone Ranger, and honestly, that film deserves an entire video essay in and of itself, just because I think there's so much fascinating stuff to unpack there in terms of its shockingly poignant anti-colonialist themes, as well as its very vitriolic critical reaction. I'm still waiting for that Lone Ranger revisionism film Twitter. You did it for Miami Vice and Mission Impossible 2. Where's my Lone Ranger army at? Anyways, my point is that as time has gone on and the world has seemed to continually forget about Gore Verbinski's existence, the more I have appreciated his work beyond just being the fun entertainment that they gave to me during my childhood. I mean, this is the filmmaker who basically founded my artistic sensibilities, the person whose art made me believe anything was possible, the one who taught me that filmmaking is something special and sacred, and that anything can be turned into an emotionally stirring story if you're creative enough. I truly do owe everything to Gore Verbinski. All of my hopes and dreams, my loves and passions, my sense of humor, my sense of empathy, the film festival experiences I've had, this channel, the lifelong friends I've made through this art form, it all traces back to Verbinski and that endless horizon.